ज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमः। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेदु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं। तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तन्मयमान।
I have explained about Vyasa and Narad and how Srimad Bhagavat was manifested. Srila Vyasadeva taught Srimad Bhagavatam to Sukadeva Goswami and he was explaining Srimad Bhagavatam in the council of Parikshit Maharaj and he was answering all the questions which he has put there. He told that Savai Pumsa, what is? Why khut?
Khut is? What is the problem?
Who has got it?
Shamana.
I never heard the clicking before.
It might be low battery sign.
Yeah.
There's new battery in there.
There's a cassette player.
No. Try speaking aggregation.
But now there is no sound.
Savai punsang paro dharmo yato bhakti radhokhaje. अहेतुक्य प्रतिहता जात्मा संप्रसीदति। एनीवन कल्टिवेट प्योर भक्ति स्पॉन्टेनियस विदाउट अनइंटरप्टेड फ्लो इंडिवरिंग हिज इंडिवरिंग थ्रू बाय माइंड बॉडी स्पीच and by various sentiments, that is mood, not contaminated with fruitable what?
Activities.
And gyan, impersonal gyan. Then it will be Shuddha Bhakti. By practicing, our soul will be so happy. If anyone is practicing Bhakti, but he is so unhappy, always criticizing others, always hypocrisy or
Duplicity,
and all these things. He cannot realize happiness in his Atma. So, the symptom, whether we are following, cultivating or bhakti, all activities for Krishna. The symptom is that always our Atma will be happy. But if not happy, we can give our hands here and see, realizing that I am happy or not. Nemi Maharaj was not happy. But a person no clothes, naked, quiet, nothing to take anything, nothing to drink and eat, no clothes, nothing, no home, nothing. That is Dattatreya. But he was happy. Because he has taken 24 gurus, Shiksha Guru, and always happy. Because he was cultivating his all endeavor for the pleasure of Krishna. So he was happy. So if you are doing bhakti, and that is pure bhakti, pure devotion, to please Krishna only, not to please yourself, then you see your atma is always full of happiness. But if anything is contaminated in that, atma will not be happy. So there are some various stages of bhakti. Bhakti is pure. Bhakti is pure. But our heart is not pure. So according to the stage of our heart, our activities, our mind, bhakti has been told in various stages. Bhakti is one, like pure water is one, drinking water. But we tell that, oh, it is contaminated or uncontaminated. Pure or not pure water, impure water. So when we tell that pure bhakti, pure devotion, then is there any ashuddha bhakti, impure bhakti? Yes. Bhakti is always pure. But who is practicing bhakti yoga? They are pure, are not pure, up to what stage they are pure. According to their level, it is told that bhakti is like this, bhakti, sarup siddha bhakti, then
sangha siddha.
Sangha Siddha, Arup Siddha, Karma Mishra, Gyan Mishra, Guni Bhuta Bhakti, like all these things. Srila Rupa Goswami has given some barometer to test whether this milk is pure or not, or how much percent water is there. And that is barometer of that is shlok, anna vilashita sunnam jnana karmana adi anabratam anukullena krishna anusilanam bhakti yuktam. We cannot judge, but a devotee in actually situated in, established in Madhyam Adhikari, he can realize all these things. What we are doing, it is pure or not. Like Jiva Goswami, he can just. And so, in Bhakti Sandarbha, he has explained all these things. So when we will read Srimad Bhagavatam, from beginning we will see either this is pure bhakti, not pure bhakti, karma mishra bhakti, jnana mishra bhakti, yoga mishra bhakti, or sarup siddha bhakti, Sangha Siddha Bhakti, or Kiyakta?
Arup
Siddha Bhakti. There is no bhakti at all. But we think that, oh, I am doing bhakti. I am serving or supporting any cows. I am feeding. Oh, Krishna, cows were so much near and dear to Krishna. So I am feeding cows. What? Paul Poshram Karra.
Nourish.
I mean nourishing this cow. So it is bhakti. We are actually serving this cow for milk. Those cows who are not giving milk, we will not give anything. But we think that, oh, cow was very near and dear to Krishna. Krishna wanted to nourish them. So I am nourishing, and that is bhakti. It is not bhakti. But if we can give whole milk to Krishna, Guru, Vaishnava, then it can be arop siddha bhakti. Arop siddha only, not swabhava siddha bhakti, sarup siddha bhakti. We have made a garden, very beautiful garden. And some fruits are given, offered to Krishna, and others we give it to market to sell, and the money is coming, and testing all this money. Then what it will be? If the whole fruits were to given in Krishna service, not single apple for myself, then it may be Sangha Siddha or anything, Arup Siddha. If you are so humble, Trinadapi Sunichena Tarrapi Sahishna Manina Manadena, for these qualities, I think you know all. Trinadapi Sunich, being so much humble, more than dry grasses. Trinadapi Sunich, Tarrapi Sahishna, more tall branch than trees. You are cutting the tree, and same time, if there is fruit, you are also testing. Trees, nothing to tell. That's why you are doing so. He will never want a little water also, even. And he will give his skull, his body, his branches, his roots, everything. Oat. He's for his whole life, his whole body is for others, not for him. So if you want to do bhajan, you should be tolerant, have tolerance like trees. You should think that how I am tolerant. If anyone is doing like this, then you will do that. Not this. Don't take any revenge. Amanina, don't want any praise for you, yourself. If you are so, you have so much, so all qualities, but think that I have no quality, really, not as a proud ego. Oh, I am so rotten, I am so
fallen.
But oh, they should tell me that you are not fallen. That should not be. And giving actual praise to others. If a man has this to extend, but he is not chanting, remembering, then what? What is the use of this thing? Nothing. Zero. It will not do anything. But if you are doing bhakti, you are cultivating bhakti, and four these qualities are there, then these qualities are called Sangha Siddha. Otherwise not. No value of these things. So, in the past times of Srimad Bhagavatam, from beginning to end, the chain, or there is a,
Steps.
Gradation.
Dhruva, Prahlad, Chitraketu Maharaj, Kapil Devahuti, in this way. Pandavas, so many. Ajamil, some greats. There are not equal, or are not Swarup Siddha Bhakti, pure devotion. So, I am requesting Brajaballa Prabhu to give a comparative
study explanation
outlook regarding the devotion or mood of devotion of Dhruva and Prahlad. So yes, sir. Then I will tell again anything. Yes, sir.
With Dhruva Maharaj, he had an intense desire for some reward in his approach to the Supreme Lord. He prayed to the Supreme Lord with some desire in his heart. So when the Lord came, he wanted to give some benediction. And although Dhruva Maharaj, he prayed with this intense desire, but when Lord Vishnu came, he said, "Oh my Lord, I prayed for broken glass, and now look at this wonderful jewel I have." But still he had some desire. He approached with not totally a pure heart. And in this way, Lord Vishnu gave him the benediction to rule the world for what, 11,000 years? And then even a further benediction that he was given his own planet, not in Vaikuntha, but also not in this world. What is that? Brahmapriya Vaikuntha, near there? In this Dhruva Loka. So that benediction he got, not to enter Vaikuntha, but he got free from the influence of the Pralaya or destruction. Whereas Prahlad Maharaj, he did not have that desire for something in return. So much he tolerated, but always thinking of the Supreme Lord. But his connection with the Supreme Lord was a fleeting thing. He got that darshan of Nrisingadev for a short time. Nrisingadev took him on his lap for a very short time. And like he said in Brihad Bhagavatamrita, when I recall this, it is like a dream, dreamt on a vast seashore. But now where am I? So, still, from Dhruva Maharaj to Prahlad Maharaj, Prahlad Maharaj is higher connection with the Lord. And then from there, the closer towards Vrindavan, then the more service the devotees. They don't want anything from the Lord at all, but they simply want to please the Lord. But I think one benediction the Lord gave Prahlad was he didn't want anything for himself, but the Lord was insisting that he said, "All right, not for me. You please deliver all, one and all. I'll take the sins on me, but let them all go and become your servants." I think like that.
Very good. Very good. Can you clear more? Anyone? Anyone can?
I think Dhruva had a desire to begin with, and then he became ashamed of it, whereas Prahlad did not have any desire to begin with at all. In fact, when offered benedictions, he just refused everything.
I could not understand. Again.
Dhruva Maharaj had a desire in the beginning, yes, when he started to worship Vishnu.
Yes.
And Prahlad Maharaj never had any desire to gain anything.
From the beginning.
From the beginning.
But why was this? Think. You should stand up and then tell anything. Not sitting.
Me or?
Anyone?
In Gita, the state chatu vida bhajante mam janu sukrita rijuna ato gigyasu atati gyanicha bharatasava. So, Dhruva Maharaj, he was approaching the Lord for some material benediction, whereas Prahlad Maharaj, he had knowledge. So, in the Gita, next verse, it's stated that those who approach the Lord with knowledge, that they are greater. So Prahlad Maharaj, he was in the womb of his mother, and he was hearing from Narada Muni. So because he had this sadhu sangha, this very high quality sadhu sangha, so he was fixed in this knowledge, and was he had this knowledge. So when he was asked for some benediction by Lord Nrisimhadev, he said that He said, "I'm not a mercantile man. I'm not a merchant. So please do not ask me to take any kind of benediction like this," because he was approaching the Lord in devotion due to his knowledge, due to sadhu sangha.
But any kind of question that Dhruva has also the association of Narad, same Narad?
Yes.
Then?
Narad Muni could see that Dhruva Maharaj had that spirit of Kshatriya, so he simply gave him the mantra to chant, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya.
Okay.
But Prahlad Maharaj, he heard in the womb.
And he has come in what dynasty?
Dhruva Maharaj?
No, Prahlad. Prahlad Maharaj, Dhruva has come in Kshatriya dynasty, you told?
Dhruva was a
Kshatriya.
Kshatriya.
And Prahlad, more wretched than him, he was demon. Then how he galloped?
Although he was the son of a demon, because his...
So he was he was some of high level than Prahlad Maharaj, because he was Kshatriya. Stand up and then tell. Very good. Very good. Attempt is good. Bolo? You can just speak. Be ready of anyone, lady devotees. Then you can tell that Maharaj is doing partiality, always asking them not to be. Don't blame, only answer very little, quickly, very quickly.
In his previous life, Prahlad Maharaj, he accumulated so much sukriti by fasting on Nrisimhadev Chaturdasi. Even it was unknowingly, he was whole day not drinking or eating anything and residing in the temple mandir of Nrisimhadev. So both he and at that time his lady friend, who also was fasting, they got the benediction in next life to become great devotees of Krishna, Nrisimhadev. So according to our previous sukriti, in this life we develop a certain attitude towards the Supreme Lord, and that may be in comparison to the verse Anya Vilasita Sunyam Jnana Karmadi Anavitam Anukulyena Krishna Siranam Bhakti Uttamam. Prahlad Maharaj had no interest in jnana or karma. He only wanted to always meditate upon the Supreme Lord everywhere. Whereas Dhruva Maharaj, he was in a situation that he wanted the kingdom greater than his great grandfather, Lord Brahma.
Good attempt, but more something.
Prahlad Maharaj, from very young, he was doing bhakti, right? From very young, or Dhruva Maharaj wasn't. He was giving bhakti. Worshipping.
Anyone of this side? Left side?
Ah, right side. They are right.
No, they are.
There are two sides.
For you, they are right.
They are left, huh? You? Why not? Follow?
Prahlad Maharaj.
No, don't lost time.
Discussing between Prahlad Maharaj and Dhruva Maharaj, we're talking about the reciprocation of love between Dhruva Maharaj that he had with Vishnu and Prahlad Maharaj and Nrisingadev. So when you talk about love, it's a two-way street, so to speak. The Lord reciprocates, and Krishna says in the Gita, as you surrender unto me, I award you accordingly. So when Prahlad Maharaj was sitting on the lap of Nrisingadev, Nrisingadev was saying, oh, this nice boy. Nrisingadev appeared from the pillar, and when Prahlad Maharaj was sitting on his lap, he was missing that parental relationship of a father. So after the incarnation of Nrisingadev, from that point onwards, when Krishna appeared, he came from a mother and father. Nrisingadev was the last incarnation that he appeared without a mother and father. So because Nrisingadev was missing that loving relationship, there must be something more. How would it be to be a father? So Nrisingadev was missing that, there was a missing of love there. There was one spot or a fragment of the reciprocation of father. So from that point onwards, Nrisingadev, or the incarnation of Vishnu, always had a mother and father. So that incarnation was the last incarnation that Vishnu didn't accept the role of mother and father, coming from the pillar.
Very good. Let us come to the point. You want to say something?
In the example of Prahlad, there was long oral reception to his Gurudev. To Narada Muni, there was submissive oral reception. In the case of Dhruva Maharaj, he simply gained a mantra and with ulterior purpose began chanting.
Very good. Good logic. Dhruv was disturbed by his father. And he was very angry. And being angry, he was weeping. That his father has not taken me in his lap. And I am deprived of this kingdom. And then he went to forest. Anyhow, Narad met there. And he tried to cheat him upwardly that you are a very little child. Tigers may come, elephants may come, bears can come, and they will swallow you. Return to your home. But his decision was lost. So he told that, I will never return to my home. Then Narada Maharaj gave that mantra. And then he practiced and he had the darshan of Vishnu. Who Vishnu? It may be Kshirodasai Vishnu in this world. Because he gave his only lok in what?
This universe.
Material world, in one Brahmanda. That place is, Dhruva place is within Brahmanda. Now we should think that he has no sadhu sangha so much, no past impression which is needed more, considered more. And if there is not past impression, then it depends on initiation,
sadhu
sangha, association a bona fide guru or sadhu, any. He had no impression he was neophyte devotee. And having anyabhilashe, he doesn't know what is karma, what is gyan, nothing. But so much desires. And it was covered. And especially he had no sadhu sangha. Narada has not given any toll that you are soul, you are this, Krishna is so, Krishna tattva, Guru tattva, Maya tattva, never. So he took darshan, and by darshan, to whom he took darshan? Khirup Dasai Vishnu, Mahavishnu or Vishnu. It has told that Narayan, but Narayan was in form of this Vishnu. And he gave a benediction to Dhruva according to his level. Also we can consider this through Brihad Bhagavatamrita, that there is superiority of worshipable deity according to superiority of devotee. And sometimes according to superiority of devotees, his worshipable devotee supremacy. Understand? Where is Navdeep? Not. What I told, you should tell clearly.
Gurudev is explaining that according to the level of the devotees, for example, we were discussing Prahlad, Dhruva, then there's also the Pandavas or Hanuman. So according to the particular associates of the Lord, then one can estimate the superiority of the manifestation of the Lord. For example, Hanuman is superior to Prahlad Maharaj. Therefore, we can understand that Ram is a fuller manifestation of the Lord than Nasinga. And similarly, the Vajravasis are superior to Hanuman or Prahlad. So therefore we can understand that Krishna is the topmost manifestation of the Lord.
No.
And conversely, according to the manifestation of the Lord, his associates will also be considered to be superior or inferior.
So this, by this point, the worshipable deity of Dhruva was Khirupa Sai Vishnu. And worshipable deity of Prahlad Maharaj was Nrisimhadev. Among three, Krishna, Ram and Nrisimhadev.
Paravastharu.
They are called Paravastharu. Nrisimha is superior than all manifestations. And from him, Ram is more superior. And from Ram, Krishna is more superior. So here, we see that Prahlad is more superior because he was worshipper of Nrisimhadev. Another thing, everything depends on sadhu sangha, association of pure devotees. Though Narada given him mantra to Dhruva, also Narada was associating with, Prahlad was associating with Narada. For a couple of minutes, he was so fortunate to have 2-3 minutes sadhu sangha or 1 hour or half hour. He got association of Narada, Dhruva. Whereas Prahlad Maharaj, he had association for 60,000 years. Knowing all the Vedas, Upanishad, everything completed his. And from birth, this was an impression of for 60,000 years. What Narada has, he manifested everything in Prahlad Maharaj. So from birth, he was a pure devotee. No ambition, no anyabhilash, gyan, karma, adi, anabrit. His bhakti was pure, not contaminated with gyan or karma. Here karma means fruitable activities, and gyan, impersonal knowledge. Nothing was in him. He did not want any benediction for mukti, salvation or worldly things, never anything. So the two tatastha lakshan were not in him. Understand tatastha lakshan? Annabhilashita shunyam, jnana karma anadi anabritam, adi anabritam. This was right. But there was some defect in anukullena krishna anushilanam. He was surely more than Dhruva. Dhruva has ambition. He was worshipping any deity of Krishna, manifestation of Krishna. But he has Anya Bhilashita. Also his activities were contaminated. His bhakti was covered by karma, fruitable activities. His knowledge was not also pure, not knowing who am I and all these things. But later on, when he became king of this earth for 36,000 years, then it may be that Narada had come. And then he will be associated. And then he may have been pure devotee. But he has not so much association as Prahlad Maharaj. But anukullena krishna anushilanam, when we think about this, then what he has done for his worshipable deity, how he served Nrisimhadev? Any service? A glass of water he has given? He has done fine for Nrisimhadev? What he has done?
Garland?
Huh?
Garland?
Nothing garland. There was no garland at the war when war was going there. And all were so much feared. All were like this. What Nrisimha will do? Where to have garland at that time? No garland. Never written in Srimad Bhagavatam that he has any garland. Only after, when Nrisimhadev killed Hiranyakashipu, he folded his hand. All were telling Brahma, Shankar, Lakshmi, go and pacify your Prabhu. We cannot go. We will be burnt. Fires are coming from his heads everywhere. All were there. When they told to Prahlad, gladly he accepted and he, running very affectionately, he jumped over in the lap of Nrisimhadev. Nrisimhadev was pacified and tears were coming. Prahlad, I am indebted to you. It became so late. Your father has disturbed you so much. So I came late. So excuse me. So I want to give you any benediction. He told flatly that I am not a business person, that I will
take benediction from you.
If I have, you should give up. Then he told that my father should be
excused.
Oh, it has been done. If anyone is not chanting or not doing anything, but his son is doing, and his son is very lapped up, he has taken Harinam, and ordinarily he is doing, Kanishtha. His Kanishtha Adhikari, even his seven
dynasty
will be purified. And if he is of Madhyama Adhikari?
14
dynasty. Father, mother, everybody. And if he is Uttam Adhikari?
21. Then 21
generation. Krishna will give some concession to them. And they will be very good devotee. So Prahlad was in that Uttam Adhikari. Dhruva was not seeing everywhere Krishna. No? But Prahlad Maharaj? Everywhere. Prabhu. In all living being, he was saying his Prabhu. And in Prabhu he was saying all. That I explained in body. So don't try to be Dhruva. Try to be Prahlad. But in Prahlad there is something lacking. And what lacking? He was not Jnani, but he was Jnani Bhakta. Among what he told this slok, Chaturvidha Bhajante Imang Sukritano Arjuna, Jigyasu Artharti Jnani Cha Bhartasya. He was Artha. That Dhruva was
Dhruva
Artha. Artha, non Artha. Artharti.
Artha was Gajagda.
And Prahlad Maharaj, Jnani Bhakta, not Jnani. That is far difference between Jnani and Jnani Bhakta. Prahlad Maharaj is Jnani Bhakta. Why? Because his Prabhu has no appetite. He is Supreme Personality of Godhead. He has no appetite, no thirst, no sukh-dukh. Above all these things, he don't want any service. He is Atma-kam of Apt-kam. He is Atmaram of
Atmaram.
So he does not want anything, he is full in him. So what service I can do? Oh Prabhu, like a son, you should nourish me. Give something. Your benediction, that I may have. But when we will go to Hanuman, to Pandavas, they are serving always, spontaneously. So we should realize all these things and try to develop our Krishna consciousness. If you are not understanding all these facts of bhakti, the
gradation
of bhakti, you cannot develop your Krishna consciousness. So we must hear and so Prahlad Maharaj has all these things, but Narada has not given how to serve the most supreme personality of God, Krishna himself. So he was not any of them, not Dasa, not Sakha, nor Vatsalya, not Mathura. After this, Kapil Maharaj comes. What is the purpose of Kapil Dev teachings?
As Srila Gurudev explained in England, the main point of his teaching is that one should hear about Krishna from the pure devotees. Sitam prasangam mama virya sangito. That is, Krishna is saying that my glorious activities become realized by the association of pure devotees, and they become situated in the heart, and that person becomes my pure devotee who hears from the pure devotee. He spoke to his mother, Devahuti, after his father, Kardama Muni, took sannyas. And in the palace that was made by her husband, the celestial palace, which was as big as a city and opulent like the king of Indra's palace. Lord Kapiladeva explained the position of the Lord in relation to the jiva soul. He explained that bhakti was the most important process of yoga. He explained very elaborately the features of the Lord's body so that one could meditate on them. He explained the qualities of the pure devotee, like he's very tolerant, he suffers by the sufferings of the conditioned souls and he wants to help them. And Kapila also explained the how the subtle elements turned into gross elements to create this material world. And the purpose of the material world is to worship the Supreme Lord. And ultimately, the main point which Gurudev was saying was that all this is possible to understand the form of the Lord, to understand how to render service to the Lord by the association of pure devotees and by hearing from pure devotees. And Gurudev explained also in England that after Kapiladev left home, his mother Devahuti became mad and she didn't at all take care of her body and she became like a mad person, not eating and not knowing whether her clothes were on or off, but just fully absorbed in mad ecstasy and in her son's lotus feet, and then she went back to Godhead and served him eternally there.
Okay. Anything? Question?
You ready? There is one other distinction between Prahlad and Dhruva that I was thinking of.
What?
You
can stand up.
Because of their relationship with their gurus, each of them having Narad as their guru, the state of compassion between both of them, after they had achieved their benedictions from their respective Ishtadev, when Dhruva Maharaj was picked up by the celestial airplane and being taken to his planet, the Pole Star, he was looking around and he felt separation from his mother. This is one person who was one of his original gurus who sent him to the forest. So he was looking around, where's my mother, where's my mother? And they said, just see, look over here, there's another airplane and your mother's on that airplane. So he became satisfied that his mother would join him in the heavenly kingdom.
Yes.
And this is in the material world.
Yeah.
The distinction between Prahlad Maharaj is that not only didn't he have a goal within this material world, but his compassion was such that because of his relationship with his guru Narad Muni and because of his relationship with his Ishtadev Narasimhadev, he was thinking not of one person, not of his mother, not of his father, not of any one person, but actually all of humanity, not even all of humanity, but every single living entity in this world. So the compassion, the difference between both of them is measured in the compassion. And this is a very great lesson for all of us, because we shouldn't try to do bhakti so that seven generations of our past family can go to the heavenly planets and enjoy or this and that. But we should actually practice bhakti so that we can please our Gurudev and please our Ishtadev. And of course, I'm not an authority on this. We'll just let Gurudev finish up.
But due to why it was? Because he has no good association, Dhruva. And I told that it's a long, long, about how much? 60,000 years. So how he will know? So at last he has something, love and affection, for attachment for her mother. But he has so much long association. No? So there was nothing in Prahlad Maharaj. So, satang prasangam avirja sambhidau bhavanti ritakarana rasayana katha tajyo sanata asu apabarga vartmani saddha rati dan bhakti anukramishyati. Before explaining this sloka, I meant to explain this sloka. Jnani prayasam udupasya namanta eva jivanti sanmukharitang bhavadiya vartam sthane sthita tanvang manovhi prayaso ajit jito api traihatar lokyam. Who has told? Our Guru Brahma has told this shlok. And that shlok who has told? Kapil Dev Maharaj. Who is senior? Who is
superior
among them? Kapil Dev is incarnation of Krishna. So he must be superior. Though he is our Guru Brahman, he has told that both are like same. Jnane prayasam udapasya. What Prahlad Maharaj had, Jnan Bhakti, something, so much thinking affluence, so much powerful Krishna. He is the creator of creator, Sarvakaran Karanam, Adi and Anadi. He is Adi of all. He is, Adi means?
Original
for all and Anadi himself. No Adi of him.
No one.
And he is Sarvakaran Karanam Krishna. To know this fact is called Jnan Bhakti. If he knowing that Krishna is so, then he cannot serve. He has no, then he will have no prem to Krishna, to that. Only that prem will be mixed with opulence. But Krishna is not controlled by this. Krishna is controlled by only whom? He is telling, Jnane prayasa udupasyanamanta eva jivanti sanmukharitam bhavadiya vartam sthane sthita tanvang manovhi prayatito jit ajito api jita trailokyam. He is telling, Krishna is ajit, he is not controlled by anyone. He is supreme personality. Anyone cannot control him. Who can control? He is telling that jnane prayasam udapasya. Give up any cultivation of your knowledge that Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead. Swamiji came this world to tell that Krishna is so on. He is supreme personality of Godhead. But I have come that you should forget this. If you want Braja Prem, you'll have to. I'm not telling for all. Those who are advanced devotees, for them I'm telling. If you are knowing always that Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead, he has no
appetite,
he has no wish to take water. He is extraordinary. He is Ishwar of Ishwar. Then there is no prem at all. Only appellants will come folded. So Prahlad Maharaj Bhakti is like this. He knows that Krishna has shape, Nrisimhadeva has shape, and he is creator of creators. His supreme personality of God. He is knowing. That is why he could not serve. So Brahma is telling that, advising us that give up this thing. Don't try to know all the tatva, jiva tatva, so much. Always observed. Jiva tatva, maya tatva.
Bhakti
tattva, jnana tattva, anything. Give up all these things. But what you should adopt? Jnane prayasam udapatya namanta eva jivanti sanmukharitang bhavadiya varda. If anyone is giving harikatha, telling Harikatha, pure pastimes of Krishna. Then you should listen, give up all that activities to know Krishna is who is the
Supreme Person.
And he is all power, he is almighty, give up of this thing. All things will come in this Harikatha. Harikatha, pastimes of Krishna includes all. Maya tattva, jiva tattva, Krishna tattva, everything. It concludes. Understand? So if you are doing, then you will achieve more. Krishna will be controlled by you, only by Harikatha, in Sadhu Sangha. You should do pranam to the person who is telling Harikatha, past time. Those who is reading Srimad Bhagavatam. Where this katha is going on? Oh, pranam to this place, to New Braja, to the home of Nirgun Prabhu and his family. Also, so much pranam. Pranam to the all listeners, all Shrota, so much, all. Especially to the person who is giving Harikatha. Oh, pranam to you, pranam to all Shrota, pranam to this place, and those who has organized this Harikatha, oh, so, so much pranam to them. On S8,
Dandavat,
Sashtang Dandavat pranam, to all, by body, mind, speech, and by all means of moods. Oh, very good katha, very good katha. Oh, I will hear it. Then he can control Krishna Balan. And he can know all the tatsa, jiva tatva, maya tatva, Krishna tatva, everything. If anyone is telling Harikatha, Krishna birth, from birth to 90th chapter of 10th canto, everything. Then he will know everything. There will be nothing to know new. And secondly, Krishna will be controlled. What controlled? Like Brajavasis. He will like Brajavasi. And he will control Krishna. Like a Sakha, Bhujam Sakha, like father and mother, not like father, mother as Devaki Vasudeva, but Jasoda and Nanda Baba, and very bosom friends, like gopis, beloved of gopis, he will be. And then what they will tell, oh, stand up, Prabhu, he will stand up, Krishna. What they will tell, Krishna will be controlled. So, to listen Harikatha in Srimad Bhagavatam, in first canto, first chapter, it has been told. Kya shlok? To hear. Harikatha jahara sunana tahara. No. Ata kya shlok taki? No.
Nityam Aptam Sulabham Plavam Sukalpam
Guru. Are nahi bhai. First chapter. If he is not hearing Harikatha, but he is chanting, remembering, doing all activities, even everything is bogus.
Samayi.
Now it has come. After a long term.
They are not giving chance to make me remember.
Oh, yes. it is fault of mine.
You become nervous.
Yeah, he became nervous.
Yes. It is our fault.
You made nervous. Yeah. So what is love?
Dharma
swanishtita punsham. If anyone cultivating everything for Krishna or anything for world, but not listening Harikatha. When Harikatha is going on, a person giving his back towards Harikatha and chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram. Then you should think that he is gone to any shop of shoe or anywhere, or ornament or anything, anywhere else, and he is struggling anywhere. He is not chanting Hare Krishna. If a man, new devotee, I have heard from my any Shiksha Guru, that if you see that any new fight devotee taking his Harinam, he is not mixing with any devotee, alone, quite alone, he goes to the bank of river, or he goes to the foot of any hill, and alone sitting in the corner of any room, and he chants, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. And he cannot sit and he is moving. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Closing his eyes, then you should think that he will go in a day or 2 days. Surely he will go. Not serving any Vaishnava, not listening Vaishnava. And he is doing. When he is feeling so much anything. Anxiety in heart, and he cannot, and he is going like this and this. Then what you should do? You should take him out of the room and out of mat. You can go, push them. And if anyone is willing that, oh, I should serve Krishna, then call him. Understand what I am telling? If anyone like this, he is not hearing any Vaishnava, he is not obeying Vaishnava, he is not doing service, and he is willing to, oh, I am going to my wife, I am now aunt, new wife, or I want to go there, I will make any room for Nirjan Bhajan, or so on, so on. Then you should tell, oh yes, you can go. You can go. But in other hand, Swamiji has told in
Nectar
of Instruction, he has told. Or I have so, heard from my so many Vaishnavas. Then you should help him to go. And if he is coming, you should help. Do like Maya. Mahamaya takes any jeev to this world. And Jogmaya, when you like that I should have help, I should serve Krishna. And Jogmaya will see, then he will become Jogmaya and help you to that. Otherwise, if you are not doing so, he will make so many lakhs and lakh problems for you or himself. So satang prasangam marbirja sambidau. Bhavantiritakaranashayana katha. In Sadhu Sangha, in the association of Sadhu Sangha, very powerful and rasamai katha. Rasamai means?
Full of rush.
Full of rush. Always flowing. And its current is eternal. Never it will dry. Always full of. Like Mansarovar, Ganga, Jamuna, Jhelam, Brahmaputra, Gomati, lakhs and lakhs rivers are coming from Mansarovar. But Mansarovar is always full of water, never comes dry, not less, always full of water. So the devotees, knowing all the Harikatha, like Narad, like Sukadeva Goswami, like Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, all. They are eternal like Mansarovar pond. Their heart like this, full of rasa. And all thoughts. If anyone go to them, they will at once melt it. And automatic a What?
Current.
Flow.
Jal prapat kisko kahte hain?
Waterfall.
Water will come. Current will come. Not only one come. Lakhs and lakhs current will come. And those who will drink even a very small sprinkle, and they will be have first sadhana bhakti, then bhava bhakti, and then prema bhakti. And that prema bhakti Krishna can be controlled. So those who have no interest in hearing Harikatha, but he is chanting something, he is doing all activities, but no taste for Harikatha, then after some time he will be very weakened and he will give up practices. But if anyone is not chanting so much, very little, but always hearing, he has taste for all Katha, then by this association he will have so much power and he will begin actually sadhana bhakti. From sadhana bhakti are of two kinds. We will come in that Upadeshamritam, Vaidhi bhakti and Raganuga. Regulated bhakti and spontaneous devotion. Spontaneous devotion is called Raganuga, and regulated bhakti is called Vaidhi bhakti. It is a chance that anyone doing, following our regulated bhakti in the path of Rupa Goswami, in the path of our disciple, acharyas, then he will have some great, by listening the Harikatha, Rasmayi Katha, and he will have some thick great, more great, and then he will control Krishna. This is the process told by Kapildev. Then, what you want to tell?
I wanted something on Dhruva Maharaj. I'm understanding the different positions, but still there was some clarification. I understood that Dhruva Maharaj went to the pole star, which was the only planet, after all the planets are destroyed, that planet would not be destroyed, so it was considered an eternal planet. So actually, is Prahlad still considered like a pure devotee, or?
He's pure. Dhruva is not pure devotee, because he has so many ambitions and he was very affectionate for her mother at the time of departure, and he has no so much association. Only by the darshan of Vishnu, his all sins were gone. But he had not still, he was not pure devotee. Prahlad Maharaj is purest devotee.
Yes.
But there was something, appellence. Mm-hmm. Appellence is another thing. If you Chaitanya Chaitanya read, then you can understand.
But will Dhruva have to come back to the material? He will have to come back in birth and death?
He has not to come, but still, like Brahma, Gyani, he has salvation, liberation. He does not return to this world, but no happiness there. Sometimes thinking, I am Brahma. So annihilation is Brahma. This is eternal, but no happiness. Any of us don't want this. Dhruva is more than this. Even being in Brahmanda, like Vrindavan is also in Brahmanda, but it is beyond Brahmanda. So Dhruva Lok is in Brahmanda, but not actually in Brahmanda, out of Brahmanda, but is still not so having so much bhakti, pure devotion. Prahlad Maharaj, bhakti is, he was pure devotee, but he has nothing to serve. Like gopis, Hanuman, or Arjun, or others. So there is some difference. Gaur Premananda. You can play here now. One kirtan should be done, they should be prepared. Anyone? You have?
We should have our teak here and everything, and then after we'll take prasad at the pavilion.
This would go afterward. But drama will be here.
Tonight?
Drama, not tonight, it is too small a place.
Too crowded.
Oh. So tomorrow there?
Yes.
So Delhi you can do? I mean 4 days we can do?
Yes. Mm-hmm. We have for tomorrow night to play with for Nisringadev, Lord Nisringadev. And
tomorrow?
Tomorrow.
Yes.
It will happen now. Tomorrow.
What he's telling?
Tomorrow. There will be a drama.
Oh, Prahlad. Very good, very good. And Haridas Thakur will be done next.
Next day.
Yes.
And prostitute.
Yes. Well. Gaon Kirtan. Mero Radha Raman Giridhari.
Giridhari.